everyone, this is Crystallized Wonder back again with another video. I'm sorry if you can hear the air conditioning in the background. I'm out here for better lighting, but I wrote a little something amid all of the protesting and this movement and being Native American. I thought that this needed to be said. I don't apologize for anything that I am about to say. We are warriors of love. We are warriors of peace. But our people have been in a war that's lasted over 500 years and is still happening today. I have seen what the alcohol has done to my people and continues to do. I have watched our reservations being torn apart by domestic violence. So many of our people have lost the battle with generational trauma. We mourn every time one of our people are killed, whether that be by police or citizen. We wear red for our missing and murdered sisters, yet we remain invisible. You can open a textbook and you think that we're not here. Christopher Columbus gets credit for discovery when we were here first. So he's put down in history as a hero, when he never even set foot on this land. So is it history or is it his story? The pilgrims landed here and it was Indigenous people that greeted them. You learn about Thanksgiving as being a time of them getting together with Indigenous people. But the truth is that they slaughtered our people and had a feast to celebrate, calling it Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving was held after each and every massacre, where Honest Abe declared it a national holiday to celebrate all of those instances where Indigenous people were raped and killed. Honest Abe then sent an army to decimate Indigenous people in Minnesota that same day. Yet we remain invisible. You know about the Trail of Tears, but you don't bother to learn about the Highway of Tears. When Indigenous people speak, we are silenced by our oppressors. When we speak of our struggles, it makes people uncomfortable. They want to speak over us, ignore us, or switch topics. Yet when it's about another minority group, they will talk and protest about it all day. When we stand with you, we stand together because we understand the pain. We have dealt with it for over 500 years, and we share this agony. We are all related, so why don't you want to act like it? Does the genocide of our people make you that uncomfortable? Because it should. But the only time you want to be us is Halloween, when you disrespect our culture. We tell you it's not okay, but then we're silenced. We speak up, yet we remain invisible. We are the people of the dirt. Our mother is poisoned throughout this land, black snakes crisscrossing over it. They poison our water, which without it, there would be no life. It's in our air, soil, heart, mind, soul, and we're dying. The poison kills our traditions. The poison has enslaved our people, put them in boarding schools. Their braids were cut, their language from the Creator taken away. This poison has stripped away our pride, our strength, and our dignity. This poison doesn't just stop at black snakes. And now, we have stood as one nation for the very first time in history. And we stand to take back those things that the poison has taken away from us. Yet we remain invisible. Our people have suffered and are still suffering, yet no one wants to see it. When the same officer that killed George Floyd had killed an Indigenous man, you don't want to talk about it. Police kill us with no remorse and without even getting a slap on the wrist. While our people grieve over and over again for an issue no one wants to see. So we grieve on our own, for our own, while no one else will. We must protect our own selves, because if we don't, know who will? When we're called savages, even now, for protecting our people. With our people meeting the Creator before their time, because of the poison that won't acknowledge our continued genocide. So who's the real savage? Our cries land on deaf ears, and we continue to fight and cry out for our people and our Mother Earth, yet we remain invisible. We stand beside the oppressed still. We fight beside you and understand you. With our fists held high, we will defeat this evil that poisons our land. But when the original people of this land have had enough of being silenced, will you stand with us? When the drums of war beat, will you be there to feel it beat with your own heart? When the war cries start, will you be scared? Or will you stand strong beside us? When the anger finally overflows after 500 years of oppression, will you be there? We scream out no justice, no peace for Black Lives Matter because they do. But when it's our turn, will you turn away from us like you have many times before? I refuse to be silent. I refuse to back down. I stand with you, so please stand with me too. We will no longer be invisible. Thank you.